September 15th in the year of our Lord, 2015. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's 2 for Tuesday. That's right. 2 beers, 2 babes, 2 hungs, 2 songs, 2 trivia questions, 2 babies of the day. I already said that. 2 vehicles of the day, 2 instruments of the day, 2 pets of the day, 2 beers of the day, I may have said, I don't know. And a whole lot of fun. It's going to be an epic show. It's going to be a weird one, too. Because, folks, I got a little treat for you. 2 real babes of the day. 2 real hunks of the day. And today's unofficial sponsor of our show is my good friend Tom Walk and his phenomenal business, Stevens Rubber Stamp and Sign Company. This guy makes it all. He makes banners, laser engraving, rubber stamps. I don't know if he's doing that anymore. Magnetic signs, candy wrappers, no kidding. Vinyl letters. Right down here in good old Yeehaw, Texas. Oh, I know it's something all going pretty much the same damn thing. Tom Walk, not Walkie, not Walker. The E is silent. Tom Walk, general manager, proprietor, legend, badass. Check them out. Stevens Rubber Stamp Sign Company, 1201 Butternut, Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas. All right, folks. Wow. So, definitely going to be an epic show. No doubt about that. I've got a couple new beers to feature. I have not featured them on the show before. And, oh, yes. That's right. And I haven't brought this out in a while either. So yeah, of course it takes two. Marvin Gaye, Kim Weston, of course, a great duet. Perfect for 2 for Tuesday, right? That's what I'm saying. Just takes two, folks. Just takes two. That's right. The original, 1965. It's a long song. Wow. Well, screw it. You know what? Let's bust out today's first beer of the day. Harpoon Pumpkin Cider. I've been waiting a long time for this. I didn't even have the balls to try it last year. There were too many other things I had. It finally broke down, so I got to buy some. Now, it's only 4.8% alcohol by volume, just a smidge below normal strength. If you've noticed, I've turned my laptop to try to combat the sun that comes through the oval window. Private winning apparatus pump technique, here we go. Of course, this stuff's out of Boston, Massachusetts. Windsor, Vermont. Great stuff, New England cider. 45 degree running right in the big assumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm sad, damn good, haven't spilled a drop yet, never have, never will. Oh God, this smells good. Cheers and beers, all of you processed Germany pies, say in Japan. Oh man, that's good. That's really good. Interesting. Apple, cider, pumpkin, cinnamon, nutmeg, ginger, cloves. Great mix. Fantastic stuff. I'm going to give this. I give it an A-. Excellent. All right. Before I get to anything further, before I get to the birthdays. Hey. I did something Sunday. Now, I gave a phenomenal podcast a shout out on Sunday. And, but I thought about it and I'm like, you know, I did something that I shouldn't have done. First of all, let's give these folks some love. Synthaholics Podcast. Folks, I don't know why their page only has 39 likes, because you're really cheating yourselves if you're not following this page. Synthaholics Podcast. You don't have to be a Star Trek fan to love this show. Oh my God, do they have a lot of fun. There's the trio of absolute exquisite wicked awesomeness that run it. You got David, you've got, I knew I was going to draw a blank, Faith and Aaron. David, Faith, and Aaron. Phenomenal trio of absolute phenomenal exquisite wicked awesomeness. And I absolutely love this show. And I will be listening every week. My good friend Justin Dimmitt appeared on Prosper. He's from Prosper. He appeared on Synthaholics. And I talked him up so highly, but I realized in promoting him and his awesomeness, it kind of brought down the other three. And that wasn't cool. So if it seemed that way, I totally apologize for that. Certainly was not my intention. I got to admit, I'd love to have it be the Fab Four. the three of you and Justin. Wow. Because you four folks know your Star Trek more than anybody I've ever met in my entire life. No doubt about that. The Fab Four. And you thought the Beatles were good? But either way, if he's going to be just guest co-hosting, that's fine. I love hearing him. I love his show, Prosper. I know you folks do, too. But, yeah. Synthaholics, you got me hooked for life. No doubt about it. I'm a big-time Three Stooges nut. And these three, you're not Stooges. These three right here are absolutely incredible. Great sense of humor. Very professional sounding, but a lot of fun. I was hooked. I listened to the whole show, and I'm already waiting for next week's show. So, folks, give it up. Synthaholics. And for any confusion out there, yours truly, the Love Doctor, Reverend Dr. B, I give you all the Love Doctor salute. And I am so sorry if there was any confusion. Certainly not my intention to diminish you three to promote my friend Justin. That's not the way I do business. I'm all about promoting everybody. And oh my God, you three are awesome. Justin, you're awesome as well. And to all of you, the Fab Four, I say cheers and beers. Synthaholics, folks, if you ain't checking that page out, get on it. Get active. Get involved. All right. Well, let me attempt to look cool again. Ha ha! That'll never happen. All right, so with that said, we got a whole bunch of birthdays for today. And right off the bat, my very own nephew. Oh, my first nephew. I love this young man. My godson, Jamie Baker Jr. JJ. I remember the day you were born, JJ. And now here you are. You're no longer a teeny bopper today. You're a man. And you're actually serving your country, the U.S. Navy. That is totally méchant génial. French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, get it indeed. Gangsta love, my name is up north, and I do it on Baron Song Day every single day of the week. Beginning. All right. Anyway, so JJ is living in Hawaii. And he says it's a lot better place to visit than to actually live there. I believe it. I've heard that. JJ, love you, buddy. Happy milestone birthday to you. And hey, just think, one more year, you can drink adult beverages legally. Unless you go up to Canada. Hey, you know. But JJ, I'm mighty proud of you, brother. Nephew, rather. Ha! Mighty proud of you, JJ. I'm giving you a Love Doctor salute. You're serving your country, protecting my freedom. I am truly appreciative of that. Love you, man. Cheers and apple juice to you. All right, next on the list, my man Randy Singletary. Now, here's a computer genius, a walking brain of a man, absolute badass member jammer I know from jolly old England. He just moved from Hawaii, ironically, to Virginia. Hey, Virginia, it's for lovers. That's what they say. Watch out. There's a lot of cops in Virginia there, Randy. Trust me. And radar detectors are illegal there, too. Well, Randy, I know your wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Bridget, former real baby today on Beer and Song of the Day, I might add, is probably spoiling you rotten for your birthday right now. Of course she is. She's a sweetheart. And you're an awesome guy. An incredible couple. Randy, happy birthday, my friend. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. How about your Houston Astros, man? Looking good. All right, next on the list, celebrating a milestone birthday today. My man, Mike Percalis. Mike, an incredible man. And Mike, I know when your real birthday is, buddy. But hey, let's celebrate it today. Do what I do. I celebrate my birthday every day. And Mike, what a pleasure, honor, and privilege working with you. Vineyard Haven, A&P, Massachusetts, Martha's Vineyard Island. Graduated with your daughter, Rebecca, an absolute sweetheart. My brother graduated with your other daughter, Melissa, another absolute sweetheart. And I know your wonderful wife, Bonnie, spoiling you right now because she's awesome. The Percalis family absolutely love you all. No doubt about it. Mike, happy milestone birthday to you, my friend. And brother, cheers and beers. Next on the list, my good friend Bob Kowalczyk. Here is a phenomenal Mafia Wars playing legend. Longtime friend of mine on the old Facebook, and we're in the best damn Mafia Wars family in history. That's right. Strays Fight United, where teamwork truly does make the dream work. Bob, what's going on, brother? Happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Looks like you're living it up today. I wouldn't expect anything less from you, buddy. I'll tell you what. Let's drink together, shall we? Happy birthday, my friend. And hope you enjoy the show. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my man Justin Lyman. An absolute badass mamma jamma that I worked with in good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. Justin, what's up, brother? Ha ha! How you doing? Hope you're doing well. The pride of Vermont, a great state indeed. Hey, you can call it Western New Hampshire if you want. I know. But, dude, always a pleasure hearing from you. I hope you're having a phenomenal birthday. Let's celebrate it together, shall we? Cheers and beers, my friend. Next on the list, my good friend, Jessy James. That's J-E-S-S-Y. A wonderful mafiaette on the old Mafia Wars. That's right. She's ultra cool, badass, and wicked awesome. And Jessy, happy birthday, my dear. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And don't hear from you often, but I'd love to hear from you. So let me know how you're doing, will you? And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. I know, folks, you're thinking, why aren't you drinking them out of here? You know why? Bottles don't work in this. I drink sophisticated. Yes, I do. But I'll tell you what, this thing's ultra cool for tailgating if you just want to buy some cheap canned beer and throw it on there. Have a lot of fun. All right, next on the list, my man Tim Coward. Tim Coward, badass crew dog that I know from jolly old England, a hardworking man, a great man, always a positive attitude. Tim, what's going on, brother? And hey, I haven't heard from you in a while. I'd like to hear from you. Let me know how life's treating you. Definitely miss working with you on the job site. And brother, squeeze me. Timmy! Ha ha! Cheer the beers, buddy. Hope you enjoy the show. And the final birthday goes to my good friend, Rory Havens. Here's an absolute badass leader of men, women, and nets that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico. Western New Mexico. Eastern New Mexico. Western Louisiana. Northern Mexico. Whatever you want to call it. Jeez. Ay, ay, ay. I am suffering from a headache. I took some Advils earlier and still hurting. Not good. Oh, well. Better being dead, right? Anyway, I digress. Rory, dude, what's going on, brother? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're celebrating your birthday. Well, yeah, you're probably getting off of work by now. Go home. Have a great dinner. Have a couple adult beverages. Enjoy beer and song of the day. Live it up, buddy. Because you know something? It's only 3 more days to your Foodie Friday. Yeah, buddy. Well, hey, Rory, happy birthday, my friend. And a big cheers and beers to you. All right. With that said, we've gone through all the birthdays. We got ourselves a couple wedding anniversary shout-outs. The first one, these are both from yesterday, September 14th. Now, this couple right here, I've known Wayne Lowry for a long time, a great badass crew dog that I worked with in good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Western Nevada. Wayne and his awesome wife, Yvonne. Wayne and Yvonne Lowry got married yesterday, 17 years ago. Awesome stuff. Got married September 14th of 1998, in case you didn't know, folks. And Wayne and Yvonne, I hope you two had a phenomenal and absolutely wicked awesome anniversary yesterday. Hopefully it was the best one yet. And hey, let's drink to that, shall we? Happy anniversary to the two of you. And I hope you enjoy the show. And then, yesterday, my good friend Johnny Arteaga. And his awesome, awesome wife, Diana, right? Oh, God, I hope I'm right about that. Johnny and Diana Arteaga. If I'm wrong about that, Johnny, you let me know, okay? I can't even read my own writing sometimes. Johnny and Diana Arteaga yesterday got married 3 years ago, September 14th of the year of our Lord, 2012. That's right. And Johnny, you said yesterday... You said, thank you very much. Looks like you guys have had a phenomenal wedding anniversary. Well, hey, do what the love goddess and I do. Celebrate your wedding anniversary every day. That's what we do. And I think you should, too. Actually, I think you do anyway. Because, man, you two are always happy. Johnny, pleasure working with you on the job site. Hell yeah, badass crew dog. Cheers and beers to the two of you. It's happy anniversary. All right. Now, time for a couple trivia questions. This first one was submitted by my good friend Justin Dimmitt of Prosper, who guest co-hosted in episode number 27 of Synthaholics podcast, which you gotta go check out again, like I said. And who is the only Deep Space Nine character to change division colors? Very interesting. Well, our good friend Alex Phillips, who I know through our unofficial sponsor, Tom Walk. See how everything ties together? He said this. He said, Worf. Ah, we love Worf, don't we? Hell yeah, we do. Alex, you have some freaking smurfalutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job. And hey, big. I'm not the salute to you. Oh, hell yeah! Let's drink to that, shall we? Sure wish it was some Klingon war nog or something like that. You know, that'd be kind of nice. But anyway, so Alex, little plug for you. I know you follow Prosper. You need to follow Synthaholics because they're phenomenal. Seriously, you won't be disappointed. There you go. See, it's all about helping each other out. That's what we do. All right. Well, Worf appeared in The Way of the Warrior in his gold Next Generation uniform. And upon taking the post of Strategic Operations Officer on Deep Space Nine, he began wearing Deep Space Nine red. And there you go. Now you know. See, you're a little smarter for knowing that. You always learn something new on Beer and Song of the Day, folks. Otherwise, it'd be a day wasted. Let's drink to that. And then our other trivia question. Nice and short and sweet. Who was President of the United States when Prohibition went into effect across the United States? Well, our good friend George Sekman of Exotic Japan, brother, you absolutely nailed it. You said Woodrow Wilson. Wicked awesome job, George. And a big, I'll got the salute to you. Ooh, hell yeah. Oh, yeah. Snap into it there, George. Hell yeah, brother. And cheers and beers. And George was on a podcast over the weekend as well. A wrestling podcast. I'm telling you, my friends are famous. Maybe someday I will be too. I don't know. See, that's what we do, folks. We all help each other out. We get stronger so that we can crush the opposition. The opposition would be negativity trying to bring us all down. We don't let that shit happen. Uh-uh, no way, no how. We take negativity and take a GFY and shove it up its ass. Show any negativity you're going to see from me. All right, with that said, guess what? It's time for our vehicles of the day, instruments of the day, pets of the day, some music, real babes, real hunks, lots of fun. Yeah, you guys are going to love this. Check out this vehicle of the day. I want this. It is a Pacific Pedal Cruiser. The Pacific Pedal Cruiser. They're trying to ban this in California. This is out of San Diego, California. You know what that is? It's literally a movable bar. No kidding. Taps and everything. Bar seats. Dude, I want one of these. Basically, the patrons all pedal power. How awesome is that? That's wicked awesome. That is a party on wheels, literally. Oh my God. I can use one of these. Just kind of pedal around the neighborhood, sucking down some good quality adult beverages, BSing with the crew, and not having the same scenery the whole time. This is epic, my friends. That is a vehicle of the day that we can all be proud of. All right? And hey, if you're against adult beverages, then hey, turn it into soda. Why not? Oh, speaking of cool things, how about this? America, damn right. How about a quadruple tandem bicycle? Look at that thing, huh? That's the Fab Four of exquisite, wicked awesomeness right there. America, damn right. I'll bet you that thing's fun to steer, though. Of course, you got to have everybody in sync pedaling. Otherwise, you're going to get a lot of bruised shins. Quad tandem bicycle. Very cool stuff. I think it'd be a lot of fun. Fun for the entire family. Let's drink to that, shall we? All right, our instruments of the day are quite unique. They really are. Our first one is very unique. In fact, this is going to tie into some of the music you're going to hear today. This is what they call a Wabash washboard. Now, the picture's small, so I'm going to try to see if this picture will fit into the Beer and Song of the Day Instrument of the Day album tonight. Look at that thing. That thing makes a lot of noise. It's more than just a washboard. It's got horns and bells and whistles and everything. I mean, that's a whole orchestra in one little unit right there. That is unbelievable. Actually, it is it's a stand-up unit. You play that thing standing up. And as you can see, That's from the 1940s right there. There it is, that same instrument. The Wabash Washboard in action with the band, the Hoosier Hot Shots out of Indiana. The home of my good friend Justin Dimmitt of Prosper. How about that, huh? Indiana. Otherwise known as Eastern Illinois, of course. All right. Let's get to our other instrument of the day. I almost forgot. Jeez. Almost blew that one there, Goober Schnitzel. How about this? Speaking of the Hoosier Hot Shots. Now, the microphone's in the middle. It's the only picture I can find where I can identify a microphone. Now, I would have loved to have had one of their single instruments by itself, but that wouldn't happen. This is the best picture I can do. Hey, if it ain't good enough for you, fire me, folks. I ain't perfect. If I was perfect, I'd be playing third base for the Boston Red Sox, because that'd be perfect to me. So there you go. The Hoosier Hot Shots microphone. That thing in the middle, quite unique. And old school, love it. All right, let's bring out all today's pets of the day are definitely weird. Today's kind of a really unique novelty show. This pet of the day, it's called, it's called a Sphinx cat. It's bald. Meow! Look at that. Green eye, blue eye. Meow! Big old ears. Bald cat. A furless cat. A shaved pussy. How about that, huh? You knew I was going to say it. You knew it. Yep. A Sphinx cat, definitely a unique kitty. I wouldn't mind having one. That is quite a unique looking cat. All right, so if we're going to say, you know what they say, right? Skin is in, why not? Let's go with a bald doggy. They're rare. Supposedly there's only four breeds of bald dogs out there. How about an American hairless terrier? Oh, look at that fella. He may not have any fur, but I'm sure he's got a big old heart. Either he or she, I don't know. I didn't bother checking the anatomy. That's not my style. So yeah, American Hairless Terrier, your other pet of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Woo! Let's drink to that, shall we? Bald doggy. Very interesting. All right. Finally, I did want to give one more shout out to a good friend of mine that I hadn't talked to in about 3.5 years. A spark-chasing legendary badass son of a gun that I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as 40% of the size of Alaska. Yeah, it's a cute state. My man, Dale Filkins. Dale! Dude! Great hearing from you last night. And I gotta give you some love on Beer and Song of the Day. Why? Because you're like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Dale, raise an adult beverage high as long as you're not driving. And drink will be right here, right now. Damn, I missed the hell out of you, brother. And definitely great hearing from you. All right, folks. Time to feature our first hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. This guy is a badass crew dog that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. And my man Dan Santoro is so famous, so well known, that even the late, great Reverend Dr. Martin Luther the King loves this man. Dan Santoro, a great man. An awesome guy, positive attitude, big time, wicked hardcore, legit no bull, Chicago Blackhawks fan. That must have been the season before they won the Stanley Cup, because you're crying, brother. Ah, Dan the Man Santoro. Ah, real hunk of the day on Bear and Song of the Day, hell yeah. And let's talk some celebrity birthdays real quick as we show off this stud muffin of a man that the ladies absolutely freaking smurfalutely love. Like Jenna Marbles. She's 29 and wicked fine. Yeah, she's going to be a future baby today on Beer and Song of the Day. Prince Harry. There's a former hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. He's 31 years old today. Actor Tom Hardy. This guy's ultra cool, badass, and wicked awesome. He's 38 and doing great. Marco Polo. The famous explorer and legend in China. Marco Polo, who was kind of a mentor to, or almost looked up to by some of his ideas and stuff, were utilized by Christopher Columbus for exploration. I was reading something about it. But Marco Polo was a definite traveler. Not in a Masonic way, but in a different way. He was born on this day in 1254, passed away at the age of 69 in 1324. Dan Marino, probably the greatest NFL quarterback of all time to not win a Super Bowl in the Super Bowl era. And I say that because prior to the Super Bowl era, They didn't have, but NFL and AFL championships. And prior to that, you just had the NFL championships. But anyway, Dan Marino, number 13, Miami Dolphins, phenomenal quarterback, and a pretty solid actor as well. I like the guy. He's 54 years old today. Two phenomenal, legendary, badass actors. Well, one's an actor, the other's a director. They're both 69 years old today. Tommy Lee Jones. I love that picture. Whole bunch of luchadors, including my man Dan Man Santoro. Right there. Trying to get to it. There he is. America. Almost looks like the Houston Texans. Anyway, Tommy Lee Jones, phenomenal actor. Absolutely love that guy. He's 69 years old today. As is legendary director, badass Oliver Stone. He's 69 years old today. Let's drink. There he is. He can look angry. Don't want to go back to Texas. Yeah, he was on vacation. And he's working down here in Yeehaw, Texas. He's got a good job down here, so he's staying around for a while. Unless he finds something better. Ain't nothing wrong with Texas there, Dan the Man Santoro. I know there's a lot of Cowboys fans, and a lot of Dallas Stars fans. But you like your Chicago Blackhawks, I love my Boston Bruins. All right, legendary mystery writer Agatha Christie, born this day in 1890, passed away at the age of 85 in early 1976. Oh, what a cute picture. Pete Carroll, head coach of the Seattle Sea Chickens. That's right, the man that gave Super Bowl 49 to my Patriots. Ha! Thanks, Pete. Did a better job with the freaking Seahawks for my Patriots than you did with my Patriots when you were just our mascot in between Bill Belichick and Tom Brady. I mean, Bill Parcells and Bill Belichick. You were our stopgap. Free Dan Santoro. Damn, Dan, I didn't know you were in jail years back. Oh, look at that. So cute. He's a dog lover, which is great because I'm a dog lover too. Now, Dan, I got to ask. I see that Green Bay Packers jersey there. And I have to ask, you being an Illinois guy, and you love good Italian food, I get that. Very cool. I got to ask, are you a Chicago Bears fan or a Green Bay Packers fan? Because if you're from Illinois and you're a Green Bay Packers fan, wow! That'd be like being from Massachusetts, being a Yankees fan. And I'd rather be kicked in the face with a steel-toed boot than to be a Yankee fan. Just saying, brother. Heidi Montag, 29 and wicked fine, supermodel. Hey, her and Jenna Marbles, 20. September 15, 1986 was a really good day indeed. How about spitball legend pitcher Gaylord Perry? He was the first major league ball player to win a Cy Young Award in both leagues. Gaylord Perry, 77 years old today, and Hall of Fame pitcher as well, 314 lifetime wins. William Howard Taft, the heaviest president of the United States, 27th president, served from 1909 to 1913. He was born this day in 1857, passed away in 1930. In fact, I know my nephew J.J. Baker knows that because J.J.'s like me. We've memorized all 44 presidents. Yes, we have. Jason Terry, NBA basketball player, 38, doing great. Nipsey Russell. Remember him? African-American comedian. The guy was a riot. Nipsey Russell, always with his one-liners. I love that man. He was in a lot of game shows back in the 70s. Very popular in the 60s and 70s. Nipsey Russell, born in the state of 1918, passed away at the age of 86 in 2005. Merlin Olsen. Part of the fearsome foursome of the old Los Angeles Rams. And then, of course, phenomenal actor with Little House on the Prairie years later. Merlin Olsen, born in the state in 1940, passed away in 2010. Theodore Long, WWE wrestling manager, 68, doing great. And finally, Zach Filkins. Oh, no, there's two more. Zach Filkins, in relation to you, Dale, guitarist of One Republic. He's 37 years old today. Keystone Light. Oh, come on, Dan. You got to do better than that. And Cheesehead. You got to... Either you lost a bet and had to drink shit beer and wear cheese on your head, or you are a Green Bay Packers fan. Dan, I need to know, brother, because I have no clue. Finally, on this day, In 1980, Mike Dunleavy Jr. was born, NBA basketball player. Let's drink, let's slam this one home. Yep, empty the brain cells of an average Los Angeles Lakers fan. Got a cure for that. Never featured this particular Oktoberfest on my show. This is Real Ale Oktoberfest. Real Ale Brewing Company out of Blanco, Yeehaw, Texas. That's right. And copper-colored beer, Bavarian-style lager, unpasteurized. That's the way to be, all natural. 5.7% of exquisite wicked awesomeness. Hopefully wicked awesome. We'll see. Probably opening up as pop technique. Here we go. Ooh, good pop, too. Like pulling your head out of your ass, you know? I think this show is going 45 minutes today. 45 degree angle running the big, something apparatus, right off the keyboard, because something's that damn good. Have a spill drop yet? Never have, never will. Cheers to beers, all you pro-sent Germany compiers, say in Japan. I'll say this, I've definitely had better Oktoberfest than this one. This ain't bad. This ain't bad. Above average, I'm gonna give it a B minus. It's pretty good. It's a pretty good beer. Real Ale Oktoberfest, 5.7%. Copper colored, medium bodied, well balanced brew for fall. Does the job. It suffices. I've had better, but it's not bad. It's definitely above average. All right, you want to know something that's well above average? A very beautiful friend of mine. That's from the Philippines. I have yet to meet her in person, and I hope I do someday. Feel like I've known you my whole life. J.N. Marqueda. Look at her, folks. Wow. The pride of the P.I. J.N. Marqueda. Absolutely drop-dead gorgeous. Total sweetheart. And, you know, down in the Philippines, it's a tropical area. And in the tropics, they have something called bananas. And here's a great song by the Hoosier Hot Shots from 1935. I love this song. Great novelty song. I like bananas because they have no bones. Ha ha! So you can already hear that Wabash washboard. What a unique sound that is. I think we need to pump that up.
We don't like to whistle and blow saxophones. We like
bananas because they have no bones. Ha! Ah! J.N. Marqueda, absolutely gorgeous, a total sweetheart, an incredible smile on you. Wow. And folks, J.N. told me yesterday she's single. How is somebody as sweet as you, as wonderful as you, and as beautiful as you single? That makes about as much sense as hating hockey. Hating hockey's just dumb. J.N. Marqueda being single, that makes no damn sense. She needs a good man, folks. She wants a good man. And I think anybody that's near the Philippines needs to talk to this young lady and let her know that, hey, a beauty like you should never be single. She should be taken care of, spoiled every day. Like I said, she's a good friend of mine, a wonderful, wonderful, positive attitude, ultra cool, badass, wicked awesome.
And I'll tell you so you'll understand.
Ooh la la, J.N.
I don't like your features, they are full of...
Tu es très jolie, you are very pretty. That's French for saying you are very pretty. Yeah, gotta bring out the language of love. Cool, huh? You damn right that's cool. I like bananas because they have no bones. Yeah, what a song. Happy music, happy lady, happy times. J.N. Marqueda. Incredible friend of mine. Look at that smile. That's a $1 billion smile, folks. You know it. Styling and profiling like Ric Flair. Woo! Ha ha! Look at that. Ain't that pretty? You damn right it is. Great song, great babe of the day. Deuces, yo, right? There she is. Beautiful, beautiful pictures of of a beautiful friend of mine. I love the outfit. That's way cool. 17's your number, huh? Nice. Listen to that. Wabash washboard. Let's drink to that. JN, we drink to you, my friend. Because you are incredible.
Because they have no bones.
There it is. There you go. Ole! So, now it's time to bring out our final hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. This guy's an acid trip. This guy's a pork dog. This guy loves life. And this guy is the most incredible, wicked, hardcore Dallas Cowboys fan I've ever met in my entire life. My God, this guy should be a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader. This man is so incredible. He gave me this here Helmut. The Over the Hill Helmut. The Over the Hill beer drinking Helmut. My man Dan Butler. There he is with his wonderful, gorgeous, exquisite, wicked, awesome, better half, Allie. Allison. Just an incredible lady indeed. Butler. There you go. Yeah! Now these pictures were submitted to the Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page long time ago during some contests. I know you can't see it very well. That's a romantic dinner. Yeah. There they are on vacation to exotic Germany. So yeah, some cool things that happened on this day, September 15th in the year of our Lord, whenever. In 2011, together with male and female, the term indeterminate can now be listed as a gender on Australian passports. Ah, cool. DNA. No, not DNA. No, that's Dan and Allison Butler. 25 years of exquisite, wicked, awesome marriage they celebrated on January 25th. Hell yeah. 125.90, they got married. He got annihilated. All right, that was an older picture. I get that. Crunk drunk, Dan Butler. Like I said, wicked hardcore Cowboys fan. You better not go to his house with some Redskins, Eagles, or New York Football Giants attire. He just might shoot you. I don't know. Wicked hardcore. True Texas man. A true homer. Sticks with his home team through thick and thin. That's what a true fan does. Dan Butler. Such huge respect. Look at this. Dan, the Beer and Song of the Day, man. Remember that, Dan? Hell yeah. Look at that. Look at what he's watching. He's watching my show in the background. He's got his Dos Equis. Got the beer helmet on. Dan, brother, I drink to you, my friend. And Dan, just give you a heads up. We'll have to talk. You might want to be here November 20th at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Justin Dimmitt will be here. So will a lot of people. I want to see you. We'll talk more. Check it out. There he is with Richard Keel, of course. Jaws in... Oh, God, which James Bond movie was that? When Moonraker? Living Daylights? Shit, I don't remember. He was Jaws. Richard Keel, great man who just passed away last year. I know Justin Dimmitt doesn't like this, but Dan, I do love it. Because Eli Manning owns my Patriots, but the Cowboys own him. And you're laughing about it, too. All right. Honestly, in 1996. Dan, are you a Texas Rangers fan? Because the Texas Rangers retired their first number. Nolan Ryan's number 34. Oh, that is a great beer right there. Wild Blue. Hell yeah. Shit. All right, Dan, let's drink, buddy. Honestly, in 1992, Ted Weiss, despite dying on September 14th, won the congressional New York City seat. That's insane. A dead man won office. Yeah, that's the kind of face I'd make, too. Yeah! Feel bad for the candidate, huh? Honestly, in 1990, 25 years ago today, Chicago White Sox relief pitcher Bobby Thigpen, first player in Major League history to record 50 saves in a single season. In fact, he went on to set a new record with 57 in 1990. That record stood for a long time, too, till Francisco Rodriguez crushed it with 62 saves in a single season. I believe that was 2011. I may be wrong on that. Oh, look at Dan. Dallas Cowboys collection of defeated team helmets. Hey, you defeated yourself. You spelled defeated wrong there, Dan. Love you, buddy. Not in that way. Don't get excited. Ah-ha. Very cool. RSA 1986. First broadcast of L.A. Law on NBC TV. Fantastic show. Oh, yeah. That was the year prior, and this was this year. Because what did the Dallas Cowboys do? They came back to beat the New York Football Giants, who gave them the damn game. So that was last year's picture. This year's picture. Like I said, the Cowboys own the Giants. They do. Yep. Aww. With man's best friend right there. Odyssey 1985, 30 years ago today. Awesome stuff. Willie Nelson's Farm Aid concert raised so much money for Farm Aid. Awesome stuff. Great picture right there. Dan the Romantic. Love this guy. Hanging out at Dick's Last Resort. He loves Prozac. Hey, Dan. You're knuckin' futz, buddy. You might need it. Shoot, I think I need some. RSA 1982. First issue of USA Today, published by Gannett Company Incorporated. Cool, huh? USA Today is only 33 years old. RSA 1979. Boston Red Sox's Bob Watson. First player to hit for the cycle in the American League and the National League, and he did it with the Houston Astros previously. Yep, first major league ball player to do it in both leagues. Single, double, triple, and a home run in the same game. That's cool. Yeah, Dan, you're right. We should drink. Let's do that. RSA 1978, Los Angeles Dodgers become the first major league team to draw 3 million fans in a single season. Look at that truck. Oh, yeah. Styling and profiling right there. I've ridden in that truck. It's a very cool truck driven by a very cool man, my friend Dan the Man Butler. Very great guy. Justin Dimmitt, you need to meet this man in person. I know you guys are friends on the old Facebook. We have a lot of fun. We bust each other's chops. So much you knocked him in the hospital once. Damn you, Justin. Jackass. Just kidding. Dan, I can't grow that kind of facial hair. I wish I could. I'm not manly enough like you, dude. RSA also in 1978. Remember this? Muhammad Ali beat Leon Spinks in 15 rounds for the heavyweight boxing championship. RSA 1971. First broadcast of Columbo on NBC television. RSA 1969. St. Louis Cardinals pitcher Steve Carlton sets a record by striking out 19 New York Mets in the single game. That's right. That record stood until April 29, 1986 when Roger Clemens struck out 20 for my Boston Red Sox. I was listening to that game on the radio, in bed. No kidding. I remember that game well. On this day in 1965, 50 years ago today, the TV show Lost in Space premieres. Yes, love that show, Lost in Space. On this day in 1963, folks, this is a magnificent picture of Dan the Man Butler. I love that picture, Dan. Epic photo right there. The Alou brothers, Felipe, Matty, and Jesus Alou. All three Major League Baseball playing brothers appeared together in the San Francisco Giants outfield for an inning on this day, 1963. All right, let's get to our final song of the day and our final real babe of the day. She's a financial wizard, an absolute goddess, a total sweetheart, very loud and proud like me, big time wicked hardcore Denver Broncos fan, unlike me. Love this girl. Christine Kitt Boswell. I told you I was going to have you as a real baby today on Baron Song Day eventually. I know. We mentioned a long time ago, Christine Kitt Boswell. Yep, you're hot, real hot, damn hot, wicked hot. Oh, she's mooking hot. Yes, you are. And folks, let's bring out some more Hoosier Hot Shots. The coats and the pants do all of the work. Wow, 1937. The song's from 1937. And Christine, you're a gift sent from heaven. How about that, huh? Yeah, digging it, you know it. See, even the dogs are barking like, oh, good God. Christine Kitt Boswell, incredible financial legend, an incredibly resilient young lady.
Come on up here, Gabriel, your time. We never give the credit. Really do.
RSA 1961, Hurricane Carla strikes Texas with winds of 175 miles per hour. Hey, Justin Dimmitt, you love Peyton Manning. So is my good friend Christine Kent Boswell, the financial wizard. In fact, Justin, maybe you're going to get to meet this legendary sweetheart, Christine Boswell, when you come to vacation in November.
The generals get the stars.
We'll talk more about that later.
And all they get is scars.
Now a baby cries for
RJ 1957 TV show Bachelor Father appears, premieres with John Forsythe. Also on this day in 1957, San Francisco Seals of the Pacific Coast League, AAA affiliate of the in the minor leagues, played their last game ever. On this day in 1953, Boxing's NBA National Boxing Alliance adopts the 10-point must-scoring system. Basically, what that means is the winner of the round gets 10 points. That record, that standard still exists today. Odyssey in 1953. Oh, that's so cute. Odyssey in 1953. KBOA TV Channel 4, Tucson, Arizona. NBC affiliate begins broadcast as well. WBEC TV Channel 13, Hampton, Norfolk, Virginia. ABC affiliate. Love it. Great picture. Odyssey 1952. The Boston Braves played the last game at their home stadium of Boston Braves Field. Boston's Braves Field before moving to Milwaukee. Oh, you want to drink, Christine? Let's drink.
Odyssey
1949. The Lone Ranger premieres on ABC television. Also on this day in 1949. WJAC TV Channel 6, Johnstown, Pennsylvania. NBC, later ABC affiliate, begins broadcasting, as well as WJXT TV Channel 4, Jacksonville, Florida, CBS affiliate, all TV stations. I love it. Three gorgeous ladies there, three gorgeous hats. Christine Kent Boswell, incredible friend of mine. Also in 1938, John Cobb sets the world auto speed record at 350.2 miles per hour. That lasted for a single day. I guess we'll be talking about tomorrow's record tomorrow. Odyssey 1938 as well. The only time ever in Major League Baseball history that brothers hit back-to-back home runs. Lloyd Wehner and his brother Paul Wehner of the Pittsburgh Pirates. How about that? And I know Paul Wehner is a Hall of Famer. I think Lloyd Wehner is too. I'm not sure on that one though. Odyssey 1930. The first ever international bridge match is held in London. The United States team defeated England. I wonder if all their competitors were at least 60 years old, because I'm convinced that you have to be at least 60 years old to understand how you even play that freaking game. Odyssey 1928. Alexander Fleming discovers penicillin. Yeah, yeah. Oh, cleavage. French for cleavage. Yeah. Lovely smile. Lovely lady. Lovely friend. Christine Kent Boswell. Your other babe of the day on Baron Song of the Day. Hell yeah. What the hell were you doing there, Christine? I have no idea what you were doing. That is interesting, though. Lovely face paint. Odyssey 1921. WBZAM Radio, Boston, Massachusetts, begins radio transmissions. I'll drink to that, being a homer. Odyssey 1916. The first tanks used in war. Britain used them. Battle of Somme. They were also called Little Willies. Also in the Battle of Flores in France. So yeah, the Brits brought out the tanks. And we found Waldo! Hot damn! Waldo, dude, finally we found you. Christine found you. Awesome stuff. Odyssey 1905, Wilbur Wright makes his first airplane flight. Yeah, you know what that means. Orville was the one that flew the Wright Flyer December 17th, 1903. Now you know. And doesn't that make you happy? Makes me happy. Sure it does. Odyssey in 1853. The first U.S. woman ordained a minister. Antoinette Blackwell. Ah, that's so cute. Lovely smile right there. I think that's our last picture of the day on Baron's Song Day. Odyssey in 1830. The first person ever to be run over by a railroad train. William Huskisson. Huskisson. H-U-S-K-I-S-S-O-N. Huskisson. Try saying that fast a few times. Of jolly old England. Ran over by a train. I don't even know if he died or not. Also on this day in 1830, ironically talking about trains, Duke of Wellington opens Liverpool and Manchester Railway. On this day in 1789, the Department of Foreign Affairs is renamed the Department of State. Funny, because don't we have a Department of Foreign Affairs again? Oh, no, it's Veterans Affairs. Foreign veteran, yeah, quite a bit different there. On this day in 1683, Germantown, Pennsylvania, founded by 13 immigrant families. Very cool. Finally, on this day in 1620, the Mayflower departs from Plymouth, England. Excuse me. With 102 pilgrims. Folks, we all know what happened. They landed at Provincetown, Massachusetts, decided not to stay there on the tip of Cape Cod, and went to what they named Plymouth, which was in Massachusetts, landed November 21st, 1620. I know. I've been there. I've seen Plymouth Rock. So, yeah, let's drink. Let's slam it home, shall we? Oh, a big guzzle. Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, I'd like to be. Folks, I'm going to feed us the head out so everybody take care of an awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't you can drive my spirit, drink all you might, kill yourself or somebody else, and drinking and driving is dumb to being a Yankees fan, and what's dumber than that is being a fan of Justine. Yeah, I should have been swallowed because I'm such a twat waffle. No shit. Beaver. What's dumber than that, though, is men's side with women or animal abuse or racism or people watch on pets or fake friends or anybody that supports the fans was a member of the Westboro Baptist Church or ISIS, things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big fat GFY. You know it. Time to eat some chilaquiles. First, I'm going to see you tomorrow with a much shorter show on Yeehaw Western Wednesday. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye.